Hi friends, this is Bharat here, faculty for corporate and other laws. This video is to understand the basics of share capital and debentures, which is your fourth chapter in law. Share capital and debentures, we can divide that into three: shares, capital and debentures. Covering up what is there in shares, you know, as per section 2 subsection 84, a share is a share in the share capital of the company. Now the beauty is, when we say shares, we deal with shares in the stock exchanges, but we call it a stock exchange and not share exchange, because as per section 2 subsection 84, shares include stock. So apart from that, when you see the authority that you have for stock exchange is SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India Act 1992, the monetary or the authority that you have for your stock exchanges is SEBI. So you deal with shares, but shares include stock, but there are more than shares and stock also. We call it as securities. So we'll go one after another in knowing up what it is all about. As I told you, section 2 subsection 84, which defines shares, which includes stock. There are two kinds of shares. One is called equity shares and another is called preference shares. You know, preference shares will have a preferential right, preference shareholders, and the equity shareholders will have voting right and differential rights. So this is one side on knowing up what is the kinds of the shares that we have. So shares and the share capital. So share certificate will get covered under section 46. When you cover issue of shares, it can be by way of premium, by way of a discount, or by way of a sweat equity shares. Easily that is covering up your section 52, 53 and 54. So easily knowing up what is there for issue of shares. Now coming to capital. When you know what is there for capital, there are different types of capital. We should write it in order, saying what is authorized or nominal capital, then issued, then subscribed, then called up and paid up capital. So there are five types of capital. If you remember the basic documentation that we have, which is your constitution of the company, we say MOA and AOA. In AOA, there are many clauses that we have. One of the clause is the capital clause. When you cover the incorporation of the company, capital clause will not get covered there, because it gets covered here under section 61. When you say overall alteration of the capital, from 61 to section 68, it will cover all the alterations. Wherever there is going to be a bonus issue or a rights issue or reduction of share capital or diminution of share capital or your buyback of shares, what is your prohibition of buyback? Everything will get covered in alteration of share capital as a heading, which covers from section 61 to 68. So apart from that, other clauses and all get dealt with in the incorporation of the company chapter, but this alone will get covered under section 61. There are different ways that you can alter the capital clause. They will try to say you can increase, you can consolidate, you can convert, you can subdivide, or you can cancel the shares, depending on the various reasons that you have. When we say section 67, we will say you have a prohibition to buy back your own shares, to purchase your own shares or securities, but it is allowed except for buyback of shares under section 68. So 67 will have an exception, which is called 68, which is your buyback of shares. That will be covered again under this particular alteration. Now coming up to the debentures. Debentures defined under section 2, subsection 30. Debenture includes debenture stock or any other bonds which is evidencing a debt, which can be based on the creation of charges or not. So creation of charge, we will say a lien that can happen on the assets of the company. So that's another chapter. But covering up your share capital, shares or debentures, whatever it is, everything will get connected with a word called securities. Securities is not defined under section Companies Act 2013, but it is defined under section 2 subsection 81 of your Securities Contract Regulation Act. If you remember at the start of the video, I was talking about the authority called SEBI, and you have an act called SEBI Act 1992. SEBI Act 92 will have objects, powers, penalties and appeal under the act, but when you wanted to define what is securities, it will not be defined in SEBI Act 1992, but it will be defined under Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. So we need to be really strong in knowing up what is your shares and debentures. So securities will include shares, stocks, scrips, bonds, debentures, debenture stock, the units of mutual fund, units of collective investment scheme, any government securities or any other rights or interests that you deal from that particular securities mentioned above. So these are the ways that you can remember your shares and debentures, connecting your share capital. So I'll again quickly sum up. You not just have Companies Act here, you also cover SEBI Act 1992 and your SCRA, Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. And when you deal with shares and when you wanted to move the transfer of shares from your physical format to the electronic format, we call it as DMAT form. When you move from electronic to the physical, you call it as REMAT form. So connecting all these things, you need to study not just SEBI and SCRA, you need to cover something called Depositories Act 1996. So it is not just Companies Act, it is not just Companies Act and SEBI, it is Companies Act, SEBI Act, SCRA, Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956 and Depositories Act 1996. So there are four different acts we will have to study when you deal with share capital and debentures. So again summarizing on what we have done on the basics, we told what is share, we told what is capital, and we told what is debentures. When we said shares, we connected section 2, subsection 84. A share is a share in the share capital of the company, which includes stock. There are two different ways of share capital that you connect it here, equity share capital and preference share capital, equity shares and preference shares. When you wanted to say preference shares will have a preferential rights and equity shares will have a voting right and a differential right. When you cover your share certificate, you will have to remember that when we covered Sale of Goods Act 1930, we would have studied something called document. Document of title is different. Document showing title to goods is different. Document showing title is your share certificate. Now, when you use a word called document, you need to understand document will get connected with your General Clauses Act 1897, because documents will get connected indirectly with instrument and that will be connected with your deeds. So when you wanted to know about deeds, you will have to study your General Clauses Act 1897, which is your other laws. The way that we wanted to connect is always be remembered, because that's how you can remember law and that's how you will have to remember law. Covering up your issue of securities, it can be by way of a premium or it can be at a discount or it can be sweat equity shares. When you say sweat equity shares, it is for the employees or directors. So you will ensure that for a consideration other than cash. So covering up your sweat equity shares indirectly, you will also touch on equity, employee stock option plan and employee stock option scheme. ESOP and ESOS will also get covered. Next, coming to the capital that I was summarizing, types of capital should be in order: authorized, issued, subscribed, called up and paid up, and you have alteration of share capital. I touched on MOA saying there are various clauses. Capital clause alone will get connected from section 61 to 68 on an overall basis. But when you alter capital, there are only five different types of capital. I already told you how to remember that. Coming to the debentures, when we said debentures includes debenture stocks, bonds, and any other evidencing a debt, which is whether or not it is constituting a charge on the assets of the company. So when we say section 2, subsection 30, when we wanted to say redemption of debentures, that will get covered under section 71. There are different ways or types of securities that you connected through the debentures. It can be either secured or it can be convertible or it can be redeemable. These are the different ways when you connect. The biggest of the four chapter, you will be able to know the basics really strong. So I hope you would have enjoyed this video, knowing up what is share, which includes stock, and what is capital and what is debentures, how you wanted to redeem, which is allowed and which is not allowed as per the Companies Act provisions. So share capital and debentures will not get connected only with the fourth chapter. It will get connected with your MOA, OA, which is your public documents of the company. It will not stop there. It will connect with your SEBI also. SEBI will get connected with SCRA, and automatically when you deal with shares that we were talking about, it will get connected with your Depositories Act 1996 as well. So this video would have given you a high level understanding on what is there in share capital and debentures. We will look out for another important concept in another video. So I hope you would have enjoyed this video. Thank you and have a nice day.